Hello and welcome. This is Siddharth here, and I'll be talking about SIM card politics. So, well, let's get started. Okay, so this is about me. I'm a researcher, a cybersecurity analyst. I'm currently working in Network Intelligence India as a cybersecurity analyst, and I'm a techie, and my areas of interest is mobile pen testing and mobile forensics, IoT, and DFIR. DFIR is digital forensics and incident response. This is my Twitter handle. You can connect me on Twitter. So in this webinar, I'll be covering this topic: what exactly the SIM card is, and how the user or a subscriber will be getting connected to a network provider with the help of the SIM card, and understanding of the SIM cards and how SIM card is working, and what all crimes can be conducted with a SIM card, just involving the SIM card. So, if someone is using a SIM card, someone else's SIM card, and commit a crime and just try to impersonate or something. So, what all things can be important for the forensic analyst while he or she is just analyzing the SIM card? So, what all data can be extracted from the SIM card? And what all data gets stored into the SIM card? And finally, I'll be talking about SIM card cloning. So what exactly is SIM card cloning, and how SIM cards are cloned, and how the cloned SIM cards work, and how they are used by the criminals. So what is SIM? SIM is a subscriber identity module, and SIM card is a integrated circuit card. It's also called as integrated circuit card. And this card is used by mobile phones to contact the network provider. So when a user inserts a SIM card into the mobile phone, the first thing is the SIM card tries to communicate to the network provider and gaining access to its network. If the network provider provides a SIM card, and the SIM card is inserted into mobile, and mobile tries to communicate to network provider. So the network provider will be, and the network provider will be gaining access to, will be reading the SIM card and what ICC ID. The ICC ID is a SIM card universal integrated circuit card identifier. This identifies the SIM card when it is first connected to the network. So the SIM card is a subscriber identity module and is also known as a integrated circuit card, and used in mobile phones which are cellular telephones which works on a GSM or CDMA, and this is a basic property of a mobile phone. Without a SIM card, the mobile phone is not a fully functional phone. So okay, so the basic function of the SIM card is to authenticate and identify the subscriber to the network. Authenticate in sense ke subscriber, when inserted the SIM card into the mobile phone, the SIM card first try to authenticate itself and try to get access to the network. So when the SIM card get access to the network, it is accessed by the SIM card first sends the ICC ID. The ICC ID is then verified by the SIM card provider. When the SIM card is verified, then and only then the SIM card is allowed to access to that network. So the IMSI number is the SIM international subscriber identity, which identifies the subscriber to the network provider. It is a universally unique number, and this number will be provided by the SIM card to the network provider. And this is the number which network provider will be getting to know, okay, what the subscriber is using and what all things which he'll be accessing to it, and what all access he is providing to the subscriber. So when the user enters the SIM card into the mobile phone, so what is the process the SIM card is getting authenticated? So this is the SIM here, a mobile device, a SIM inserted into the mobile device and the operator tower and the operator database. Okay, so when the firstly the SIM is inserted into the mobile phone, the SIM sends the IMSI number to the mobile phone. The mobile phone will send the IMSI number to the network operator. The network operator will be sending this number to the network operator database, and he will be asking, he will be searching for the, in the database, okay, what exactly the key is for this IMSI number. Okay, so IMSI number is associated with the SIM card, and an operator will be having the database containing a SIM card, IMSI number, and the key for the associated key for that IMSI number. So from the database, he will be accessing to that key, and in return, he will be generating, database will be generating a random number which is signed with the associated key, and a number is computed, a computed number, and the number is then encrypted with the encryption key. So the random number is generated by the network provider, and the network provider will be sending this random number to the mobile phone. So SRES is the signed response which is sent by the network provider to the mobile phone. And KC is the encryption key which operator will be encrypting the IMSI number and the random number actually. And the random number is then sent to the mobile phone, and mobile phone will in return send it to the SIM card. In return, the SIM card will be signing the number with the key with it, and this key will be used to encrypt the SRES response. Means a signed response will be generated, and the SIM card will be encrypting it using the encryption key. And this encryption key will be used, will be added to the signed response, and this signed response plus encryption key will be sent back to the operator, and operator will be verifying the SIM encryption response key from the database and from received from the SIM card or the mobile device. So SRES2, operator will be checking SRES2 is equal to SRES1. If both the values are matching, then and only then the SIM card will be allowed to authenticate to the network. And once the SIM card is authenticated to the network, it will then be able to use all the services which will be provided by the network provider. Okay, so SIM card, this is the file system of the SIM card. SIM card file system is in a hierarchical format. The base is the master file. The master file is the root file of the file system. And under the master file, inside the master files, there contains the dedicated files. Dedicated files are the files of subfolders into the master file. And these files are also connect or also have elementary files, which actually contain the data. So it can be seen here. Okay, master files have a dedicated file, and dedicated files are the subfolders which will be having elementary files. Okay, so elementary files will be the files, the actual data which contains under the GSM dedicated file, it will be containing IMSI number of the SIM card, the LOCI is the location information, and further elementary files under the dedicated file of a GSM. And this is the structure, dedicated files. There are three folders, three dedicated files which contain elementary files inside it, and which will be used by the network provider to get access or gain information from the SIM. And the telecom part, the dedicated file which have a telecom information, contains the abbreviated dialing numbers. ADN is abbreviated dialing numbers, and these are the numbers which will be the operator will be getting from the SIM card, which are dialed numbers or dialing numbers, stored dial numbers or the logs. and SMSs. The SMSs are also stored on the SIM card. The SIM card stores SMSs. Earlier, the SIM card used to store SMSs inside it, and after some time, as the technology increased and it's after that, the SIM card does not store information due to the lack of storage. So the SMSs are stored onto the mobile or mobile device, which contain the more amount of storage, so that the SMSs and all information can be stored onto the mobile device and not on the SIM card. So MSISDN is the Mobile Station International Subscriber Directory Number. Basically, this is the file which contains the link to the SIM card and the number. So this file contains the number which is linked to the operator, and operator will come to know if this is the number and this is the directory exactly from where he will be, or you subscriber will be accessing or using the services from. And basically there are more files, and LND is the last dial number, and this will be the last before that means last number which will be which the subscriber dial, like basically suppose subscriber is dialing a number, and the logs are stored onto the SIM card, and SIM cards the contacts last dial number will be stored into the SIM card. So SIM card will be having this number, so it could be extracted from the SIM card. And dedicated files and elementary files. So ICC ID is an integrated circuit card identifier. This is the ID of the SIM card. So what crimes can be done with the SIM card? So what all crimes can be done with the SIM card? So basically, I will give you an example. Suppose a user or a fraudulent person is having a SIM card, or a fraudulent person is having access to your information. Suppose a user is gaining information from social engineering or social media. A user is gaining access, and he or she will be doing recon on some person. So a user will be victim, a fraudulent person will be targeting a victim, and he will be gaining a lot of information, basically the information which will be helping him to get to answer the questions which a service provider will be asking. If the fraudulent person or a thief will be calling to a SIM card service provider, and so in return the service provider will be asking him questions, hey, who are you or how can you authenticate yourself, the thief will then give him doing recon on the person, on the victim, and gaining a lot of information through the social media or social engineering method, and he will be collecting all the information which will be used by the thief, and he will be easily answering the questions asked by the service provider. So if a person is posting, a victim is posting on social media a lot of information, okay, he's here and his birth date is this so and so, and he's staying here, he will be out of the country for so and so reason, and lot of information will be posted by the victim on social media. So a criminal minded person, what he will do, he'll be collecting this information from the social media, and he will then be using this information against him, and he will be, once the thief or fraudulent person will be getting enough information which will be used by him to just answer the simple questions of the service provider, he or she then will be contacting a service provider and asking, hey, this is the thing, my phone or is stolen or lost or damaged. So the person, service provider, he will be asking for the authentication, and he will be asking for some questions regarding personal questions which a thief should answer, and thief must have collected a lot of information so that he could answer these questions. So what happens if a service provider person is asking for the asking questions, and the thief will be answering the questions, if all the questions are correctly answered, the service provider will be disable, if the thief will be telling the service provider to disable the SIM card from the older phone and just enable the SIM card which he or she is having currently. And this will be the SIM card which a person having with him. So what he does, he will be turning the SIM card on which he or she will be having, and that SIM card will be used to create a new ID, and this SIM card will be used for further processes. And once the SIM card is with the person, with a thief, he will then be calling. The SIM card is activated, and now he'll be calling to the bank, person's bank. So what he does is, suppose he calls a person's bank, stating he is the person who is intended to be. So he will be asking for a password change for the internet banking account, and in return, the banking person will be sending the information or OTP to the service to the thief's mobile number. So the number will be with the thief and fraudulent person, and he or she will be gaining access to his OTP, and using that OTP he will be gaining access to victim's bank account. And bank account, once he get access to it, he can just transfer funds and what other things he can do. So this is just an example okay, what things can be done with the help of a SIM card if a SIM card is into the wrong person's hand. So he will be getting access to all these things. Fraudsters gain access to social medias and social engineering, and they end up with a SIM card. They just swap the SIM card from the, with the help of a service provider or a network provider, and they just get access to the bank accounts, and they just try to get all funds transferred, or just get access to their accounts and just transfer all the money to the another account or the account which thief or fraudsters are running. So SIM card data analysis. So what data can be analyzed, or what data can be extracted from a SIM card? So basically, the SIM card contains a lot of information which can be extracted, and the data which SIM card contains is very sensitive, and if the person is having access to that data, he or she can be using this data to just forensic analyzer, if analyst can analyze the data, and he or she can gain a lot of information from that. So basically, the SIM card contains the first thing is ICC ID. The ICC ID is a integrated circuit card ID which is stored onto the SIM card. So this is the data stored on the SIM card. The user identity, location information is also stored on the SIM card. Basically, the SIM card will be getting access to a location with the help of a LOCI. LOCI is a file and under the elementary files, and the SIM card works on a location network basis. And if suppose a user is traveling from one place to another, so the last location network will be stored on the SIM card, and when the new when he land up to the new network, he will be the SIM card will be sending the data to the network provider, and the network provider will then be changing the data onto its location information will be changed there. And location information once changed, then you will be knowing if the network provider will be coming to know, okay, this person is into the roaming network, and he will be changing the data network from there. So the location information is also received from the SIM card. The phone numbers of calls made are received. The phone numbers, suppose the user is dialing the number, and the logs of the phone calls are also saved onto the SIM card, and this information can also be gained from the SIM card. So the last numbers were made to dial to some number or some dial to or another number or some information, and received numbers of calls received by the network provider are also available on the SIM card and can be obtained from the SIM card. So network authorization data. So when the SIM card is powered on, the authorization data is sent to the network provider and also stored on the SIM card. So this information will be also recovered from the SIM card. Contact list is basically a phone book contacts which the SIM card is storing on, and SIM card will be storing a lot of contact details, our contact phone book contacts, and this information is also available. And when the forensic analyst extract this extract the SIM card information, he or she will be getting a contact list also. SMS messages is a very important part. The SMS contains a date, time, and a recipient, the name of the recipient or number of the recipient. So if suppose a user received a text message and he or she deletes the text message, so deleted messages will also be recovered from SIM card, and deleted messages are very crucial part. Analyst will be getting to know if this message is deleted. So this contains of some suspicious information, why the message is deleted. So this all information can be extracted from the SIM card. So how to extract the data from the SIM card? So first of all, to extract the data from the SIM card, the forensic analyst will be using a SIM card and will be connecting to the SIM card to the computer or machine, which then will be using some sort of tools to extract the information. There are a lot of tools available in the market which will be used to extract the information from the SIM card. So there are tools, example SIM card analyzer, SIM analyzer, SIMCon, SimPool, and access data, mobile phone examiner. These all tools can be used by the analyst to perform the activity on the SIM card and get access to or just read the SIM card and what all data is stored in the SIM card. So the first step is to extract the data from the SIM card is insert the SIM card. And one thing is user will be using analyst will be using the SIM and he will be not able to just directly plug the SIM into the SIM into the machine or computer or lap or something. So he'll be using a SIM card reader or writer. It is a sort of card reader which just reads the SIM card data. And analyst will be using it to plug it into the USB of the machine, and then he'll be able to extract the information or just run the tool, and he'll be able to see what all information the SIM card contains. So when the reader is inserted into the SIM card into the machine, after SIM card reader software will be able to get the information. Will be a SIM card reader or tool which will be used to extract the information and it will be analyzing the analyzing the file system of the SIM card. The file system, once analyzed, he or she will be able to see the structure or a hierarchical file system which will be used to extract the information. After the SIM is read by the application, it will then display the data. Once the data is displayed, it is ready for analysis. So once the reading is completed by the application will display a lot of data. And as I mentioned, it is a hierarchical file system, and it will be shown to the. It will be shown to the analyst or person, a user. So this information will be shown in the hierarchical format, and the hierarchical format will be then the user will be able to see the file systems of the SIM card. And the file system contains a different amount of data and different types of data into it. And once the user will be able to access this information, he will be using it to get information extracted from the SIM card. So when a user is using the SIM card and creating or analyzing a SIM card. So first of all, the user or analyst will be using this to analyze. SIM card to analyze, and the software will be used to analyze the things So he will be the SIM. Basically, the SIM card will contain is having a less amount of read and write times. Means a user is not able to read and write times maximum times as a memory card or a pen drive or something contains. So the SIM card's lifespan is less as compared to other devices. So it is better to create an image of the SIM card and carry the further analysis on the SIM card on the image which is created from the SIM card. This will be helpful when the user is working on some case and he will not be having a SIM card all the time with him. So what he will do, he will be just using this image for doing the analysis and not the SIM card. So this will be helpful when the image is used and not the SIM card. So the read and write part is just skipped. So the read and write is not done again and again on the SIM card. And this will be helping to just not complete the read and write cycles of the SIM card. So and in turn, this will not be damaging the SIM card. But if the user reads and writes multiple times on the SIM card will permanently damage, and it will be creating the SIM card if damaged will be creating a lot of havoc or problems with the users. So it is better to create an image of the SIM card and create a further analysis on the SIM card image. Okay, so what is SIM card cloning? SIM card cloning is a process of creating a copy of the SIM card and user will be creating a clone of the SIM card, and once the clone is created, he or she will be getting access to both the SIM cards, because it is basically the clone of a SIM card. So what all information is getting into original SIM card will be also reflecting to the cloned SIM card. So once the SIM card is cloned, the same file structure will be reflected to the cloned SIM card, and the cloned SIM card will be having all the information of the original SIM card. And if suppose a original SIM card is having a call or a SMS message received, so the cloned SIM card will also be receiving the same SMS or same call. And if suppose one user or original SIM card is on a particular call, so the next thing will the next clone SIM card will not be able to access a phone call or not be able to receive any other phone calls, because if suppose someone is dialing to the another SIM card or SIM number and the original SIM is on call, so the information original SIM card is on call. So the information that the SIM card cloned SIM card is having is the same as the original SIM card. So the person calling will be getting to listen. Okay, the person is on another call or is busy. So SIM card cloning process. It is the process of cloning one identity to another SIM card identity. Copying one identity of a SIM card to the another, and there are tools which you can use to clone the SIM card. And SIM card cloning is not legal basically, and you cannot clone the SIM card directly of any of the person. You just need to you will be facing some serious things. So SIM card cloning. Extracting information from one SIM card and writing the information to the another SIM card. So user can use this clone card and legitimate card or original SIM card simultaneously. And for creating a clone of a SIM card, user will be accessing the original SIM card physically. So while creating a clone of a SIM card, a user will be using the original SIM card, and for about half an hour or so, the original SIM card physically is needed by the user to create a clone of it. And once the clone is created, there is no need of original SIM card, and a user can use a clone SIM card too, and what all things are used or what all services are used on the original SIM card can be same used on the clone SIM card. So what is the purpose of cloning a SIM card? So basically the purpose of this is to make to do a fraudulent activity or create commit a crime. So the purpose is basically clear: making fraudulent calls, getting owner messages, or if someone is spying on some person, so he will be using the SIM card cloning thing to just clone the SIM card and just gain access to these personal things. And if suppose a card is cloned, person will be using it to get into the bank details or what all things, and using the internet on owner's bill, using phone to commit a crime, getting personal information of owner, listening over user's call. So these all things can be done. These are the purposes which why the SIM cards are cloned. So how to clone a SIM card? So this is a reader which I was talking about. This is the reader where the SIM card will be inserted and the USB part will plug into the system and just read the SIM card with the help of the tools. So when the SIM card is inserted into a computer or a machine, a SIM card will be using some will be getting getting read with the help of a tool or a software which will be reading the SIM card's file structure, and in return will be displaying the file structure or the information inside the SIM card to the user. So requirements for SIM card cloning are basically a SIM card which is to be cloned and a blank SIM card or programmable SIM card which are available in the market. You can use that SIM card to use this use or clone the original SIM card and write the information to the programmable SIM card. And a Windows machine. A Windows machine is basically where you plug in the reader, insert the SIM card into the SIM card reader and extract the IMSI number. When the user insert the SIM card into the machine, he will be getting the information, what all information associated on the what all information is available on the on the SIM card. And this information will be very useful. And if the the IMSI number is very much useful, and this is the subscriber identity which is used by the SIM card to identify the subscriber, and the key is the file which which is used by the network provider to authenticate, and the key is used by the network provider. The network provider contains the key associated with the IMSI number onto his database, which is then used to just access the SIM card or just communicate to the SIM card. So this information can be extracted from the SIM card, and with the help of the software, you just need to copy the SIM card and copy this data from the SIM card, and you just need to plug a blank SIM card and just write the data from the original SIM card to the clone SIM card or the blank SIM card. The blank SIM card will be just as a replica of the original SIM card. So once this process is complete, the user will be having the clone SIM card which is ready for use, basically MS use. So when you insert a SIM card into the tool or a software, the information which is extracted is in this form: the ICC ID of the information, the authentication code, and basically this is just a part of information, and you will be getting more information into detail. And the hierarchical file structure is also displayed on the once the SIM card information is extracted. And user needs to plug the SIM card and just copy the data from this SIM card and write to the blank SIM card, and the blank SIM card will be able to use by the user. So user's SIM card is getting cloned, or user SIM card is cloned, so what is the how the user will be knowing this SIM card is cloned? This will be affecting the mobile phone user's bill, The bill which will be generated by the service provider, and this will be affecting a large amount of bill amount, and the bill amount will be increased. Incoming calls will be received by the user, which is basically a wrong number, or basically another person, the clone SIM card user, will be using the SIM card to make calls and receive calls. So his calls will be also redirected or also be reflecting to this original SIM card. So the same thing will be happening on the both the SIM card. So if a clone SIM card is getting a SIM call, so whatever calls will be received on the original SIM card will be same reflected to the clone SIM card. So when you receive a bill from a service provider, or you just access to the bill of your mobile number, you will be seeing this all unknown numbers are dialed from my phone or from this number or received on this number. And if suppose you have not dialed this numbers, so you will be knowing this numbers are not dialed by me, and this is something suspicious thing which is not normal. And the wrong numbers are also the thing. If suppose the user is a clone user, clone SIM card user is dialing a call and in back receiving the same call again, and it will be wrong number for the original user. He will not be knowing okay, this is a user, he'll be he's dialing this number, he'll be receiving this number. So, and another thing is it is very difficult to place outgoing calls on the original SIM card, because clone SIM card user will be dialing the number, or just he'll be using the phone to just call to the number, or just use this number to dial another and just talk to something. And so the original user will not be able to access the information, and original user will not be able to place the outgoing calls. So this will be affecting the user, and this is the thing when user will be knowing that my SIM card is cloned. User will be knowing these are things are happening, and this is not a normal thing. So my SIM cards will be cloned. So my SIM card is cloned. So he or she will be contacting a service provider, and in turn he will be getting to know okay, this is the SIM card which is used from this location and this location too. So basically the SIM card is used from both the locations, so this is a suspicious thing. And then the user will be changing the SIM card or just blocking another number, and the process is. So how to prevent the SIM card from getting cloned? So the user itself, a normal user, needs to know okay, SIM card, a phone needs not to be kept on a unknown places, or just leave the phone on unknown places, or where you are away from that place and you don't know anyone on that place, and you just leave your phone away from you in unknown places or suspicious places. If the user is getting access to your phone, he will be using your SIM card to just create a replica of it, and he will be then in return using this clone SIM card to just use. You'll be using this clone SIM card to just get access to your personal information, and then you'll be using all the information, the bank details and all things. So another thing is when you are going to a service center of a mobile phone or something, so you just make sure it is an authorized service center, and if you are submitting your mobile for some service related stuff, or you are just submitting to just refresh or reset your phone or something, so just make sure it is an authorized service center, and make sure okay, you don't submit your SIM card along with your mobile phone. Just if you are submitting your mobile phone, and keep in mind you just need to get your SIM card from that device, and you just need not to give your SIM card to the user or a service provider. So before you submit your phone, you can you just need to plug your SIM card out, and you just do not give your SIM card to anyone you don't know. And one thing else can be done, you can lock your SIM card with a PIN. And this is the PIN you can ask your service provider. He will be giving the SIM PIN, and with this PIN you can lock the SIM card. And if suppose the mobile is rebooted or the SIM card is plugged from one mobile phone and inserted into the other mobile phone, he will be using SIM card plugged on the other mobile phone. So the user, when starts the mobile phone, he will be getting to enter the PIN on the SIM card or on the mobile phone. So once the PIN is authenticated, then the SIM card will be turned on, and then the user will be able to access the services. Until then, the user will not be able to access any of the services of the SIM card. So this is the helping thing. When the user will enter the PIN, then only he will be getting access to your SIM cards, or he will be using the services on the SIM card. And this PIN will be using when if you change your SIM card, or just your SIM card is damaged, or you need to change the SIM card. So when you when you go to the service provider, he will be asking you the PIN code. The PIN information. So the PIN information will be provided by the user, and this when the user is providing this PIN information, then the user will be getting the access to the SIM card or the services related services associated with that SIM card. So basically, this is the thing. And one thing I'll be telling will be to inform you that SIM card cloning is not an easy process, and this is not and the SIM card cloning is not a legal process. If you are just trying to clone a SIM card, or just trying to get access to someone's SIM card and just try to clone a SIM card, so you will not be this is not a legal process. You just clone a SIM card and just try to have fun something with your friends or some. And the cloning process is not easy, and you need to have taken notice in mind that when the SIM card is plugged in, you are not having much. You will be not be having much amount of read and write times because the SIM card write structure will be blocked, or SIM card will be damaged after certain write attempts on the SIM card. So after certain write attempts, the SIM card will be blocked and will be damaged, and no further process will be carried on this particular SIM card. So keep in mind that you don't just try to have this information, get extra information from the SIM card, and just need not to create a clone of a SIM card. So if you are cloning a SIM card, you just try to just create an image first. First, the image is created of the SIM card, and this image will be used. And if you are performing some analysis on the SIM card, this will be the information where this will be the thing which is very important. This is very important information which the SIM card is carrying, and the SIM card information is very important. If suppose you are working on some project or some activity which is very important and which contains a lot of suspicious information, and you just you are just trying to get information extracted from the SIM card. So if you are trying to get it multiple times, or reading the information multiple times from a SIM card, so it will just try to damage the SIM card. Instead, you can create an image of a SIM card, and after the image is created, the image will be used by the tool. Image is used on a particular tool to gain information, and this information will be saved in the image, and image file is in the machine or a computer. And after that, you can perform analysis on this image file, and with this image file will not be affecting to any of the SIM cards and physical SIM cards. Once the image is created, the SIM card is safe to leave until you need something more again. So There are a lot of tools which create the image of a SIM card, and basically most of the tools does not provide exact information, or a single tool does not provide a lot of information. Basically, a tool can provide much information, but not all information will be provided by a single tool. If suppose a single tool is used to create an image of a SIM card, and another tool which is using to just clone a SIM card, or just get read the data from the SIM card. So it is possible that this tool is just reading the data from the SIM card. So it will not be extracting or writing the data to another SIM card. The another thing is, if a tool is reading from the SIM card, it is not necessary that this SIM card will be this tool will be used to just extract the information and just store the information on the computer. So all the tools do a specific job, and this specific job specific tool is having some limitations. So these limitations are included in every of the tool, and you just need to use a specific tool what you are trying to get information on the SIM card, or just trying to clone a SIM card, or what all things. So basically, you need to get access to the tool, and you just need to know what tool is useful in this type of scenario. And after that, you will be using that tool to get access to this SIM card. So this is all which I wanted to share. And any questions from your side? So to prevent the clone SIM card from cloning, user can do is to prevent the SIM card from cloning. The user can do is filter the SMSs or the information, or handset SMS firewall, or block the SMSs on the SIM card from receiving from the SIM card. So SIM card cloning without touching. So it depends on who you are and what is the risk for the job. You can clone a phone and then get the SIM clone. If you have access to necessary info, you can just clone a SIM card. If a user is having the ICC ID or IMSI number of a subscriber, he will be using that to clone a SIM card. Making a second SIM with that information needs circumvention of cloning prevention features. The hardware which is needed to get access to the SIM card is mobile added SIM cloner, and mobile added SIM cloner is a tool which is provided which is available online and will be used to clone a SIM card, or just read the SIM card, or extract information from the SIM card. So Arshad Javed is having a question. If there is always one clone card already there, then how does a duplicate SIM card block the original? So the cloning is a thing when the user will be not knowing his SIM card is a clone, or just he will be not knowing until the bill is generated, or he will be contacting the service provider or network provider for that thing. And the cloning is different from swapping. In swapping, a user will be able to know, and if the swap is done, the SIM card, the original SIM card, will be blocked from the network, and the user will not able to view the and will not able to use the SIM card. Do they change the K1 or something? So K1 is the key, which is the key which is provided by the service network provider to the mobile device, and if the mobile device is sending that key to the SIM card, so the SIM card will be sending this, will be using this key to just authenticate itself to the network, and this is not the key which will be used by the clone SIM card. Or the same, if you are creating a replica of a SIM card, the same same hierarchy or the same information is extracted from the original SIM card and is reflected to the duplicate SIM card. Mobile edit cloning tool, does it clone SIM, clone 3G and 4G SIMs? So basically, 3G SIMs are able to available to clone. And the 4G SIM are not able to clone on the particular period of time because the 4G SIMs are upgraded to a newer technology which just blocks the SIM card to get cloned itself. So it is limited to the 3G technology. In future, they will be developing to just avoid SIM card cloning, and in later stages, technology will be more ahead, and the user or fraudsters will not be able to just clone the SIM card. Mikey Alive is having a question. Can you hardware for SIM cloning? A hardware is a card reader will be using for cloning the SIM card. This card reader will be having a read and write access. The card will be writing, reading the information from the original SIM and just transferring or writing the information extracted from the original SIM to the duplicate SIM or a cloned SIM. So we'll be using a read and write SIM card reader, which will be using to just clone a SIM card and write the information to the cloned SIM card. Arshad Javed is having a question. Once blocked, can we check that changes are done on the duplicate SIM card using the card reader? Once blocked, if you are blocked, you can if a duplicate SIM, you can just get access, or you can just know what all changes are made. But if you are having a clone SIM card, you just can access to calls or text messages or data. So it will not be getting to know to the original user. This is the thing. This is the clone, and this information will be available, or this is the added information. So eSIM is a different thing. eSIM will be available on the future SIM, future phones, and this will be embedded onto the hardware device or hardware of the phone. And it is also a hybrid SIM, which is onto the chip of the phone. And this hardware will be will not be able to just if you are porting, if you are using a eSIM and you are porting to the another service provider, so you need not to get another SIM card, or you just need not to change the SIM card. The original, the SIM card embedded onto your device is enough for you to just get access, or you just need to just download the information from the service provider and get access to it. And hybrid SIM, it can be used. It is a combination. This is the eSIM, which is a concept, which is a combination of CDMA and GSM, and it is in combination known as a GSMA. Okay, so we'll be wrapping up.
All right, thank you all for listening in. If you have further queries, please write to us. We will be very glad to answer them, but our time is up for today. We will come back again next week with another seminar. Thank you so much.